Most people get up in the morning and they make a cup of coffee and they make it in a certain way, and they do that every morning. And it makes it very ritualized, and it starts their day and it gives a rhythm to their day, and it's part of their regimen. Three things that go into making a good cup of coffee. One is the proper grind, two, proper water temperature, and three, a clean pot or urn.
Here at Brennan's, we serve a dark roasted blend of chicory, and it's the chicory in the coffee that makes the difference between a good cup of coffee and a great cup of coffee.
I make the coffee on the dark side. People like to know that they're drinking coffee, not that they're drinking water with something added to it.
Absolutely clean utensils. Freshly ground coffee, and boiling water from the cold tap.
Nothing better than New York water for making coffee.
Well, the most important thing about a cup of coffee is that 100% Colombian coffee is used.
We serve here special coffee, which is called Madras coffee. The coffee beans are from India, Nilgiris, and freshly ground and served very hot.
In order to enjoy a good cup of coffee, should be long, as plain as possible. Just maybe a little bit of sugar.
Plain, no sugar, a little drop of salt in it.
Here at the Moon Dance, we put a pinch of cinnamon in there, which really contributes to an outrageous cup of coffee. It adds aroma and more flavor to it.
In our coffee brillo, we put lemon, orange, cloves, and we put a few secret ingredients in this, and it comes out very good.
You make a Turkish coffee, we boil it over 5 or 10 minutes. It becomes very sticky.
What makes a great cup of coffee is what you have with it.
Coffee is part of life.
Good cup of coffee.
Great.
That's a good cup of coffee.
Ah. I'm telling you why I make the coffee here, you know. I don't use it too much water. I put 2.5 gallons of water for 1 pound of coffee. I make a good coffee because I use the best coffee first, anyhow. Vasilaro is the best coffee. I change a lot of coffees here, you know. A lot of coffees I change. The Vasilaro is the best. For the Broadway, he's coming over here for coffee, taking coffee for Broadway. Nice.
Candid Camera has used famous celebrities in all kinds of absurd situations just to catch people's reactions. And I'd like to show you one of my all-time favorites, which was first shown on television in 1969. It features that comic genius, Buster Keaton.
As you know, Buster Keaton never says a word, but you can almost tell everything he's saying. First, he needs a spoon. And watch what happens to his watch in his very first movement. He shakes the salt. Now, next, after he gets his watch all dried, it's going to come the problem of what to do with the napkin that he's used to wipe it. Now, watch how he disposes of that. A sandwich now and a cup of coffee, and watch very carefully. Oh, first he's got some more paper to dispose of. We thought so, Arthur, but she comes right back with her pocketbook. She wouldn't miss this for the world. Now you have to watch that coffee cup. Now, you've seen him at work once, so you know almost everything he'll do, but here are a few more things. Now he sits next to a couple, and she can peek at him through the mirror at the end of the counter. Watch this now. See, her husband gives her a little running description of what's happening. Now, this is just a pure inspiration. This little thing with the glasses is just ad-libbed. Watch. Now, you know what's going to happen with a coffee cup, but watch how exquisite. The timing is just perfect. With that sad, unhappy, wonderfully funny face.
Keep smiling, folks, and let's have a cup of coffee.